Hi, my name is Mark, and I'm going to take you behind the scenes of enlightenment. Now, this first video is just going to be an experiment. I want to see if I can get away with using that song at the beginning, and if I can, I want to use that at the beginning of all the videos. So, the first question is, what was my spiritual practice? Or specifically, what was I practicing at the peak of my spiritual search? And after I thought about that question, I realized that the practice, that I was doing was practicing death. I was practicing how to gain the courage to kill myself, as if I was taking my head and submerging it underwater and practicing drowning myself. And I'm not trying to be provocative when I say that. I'm actually being quite literal, and I'll show you what I mean when I say that spiritual practice is tantamount to death, to killing yourself. Typically, we go through life experiencing life as a continuum, as a seamless continuum, when in reality, life is a series of flickers, flickers of moments. And in between these moments, it's stillness, inactivity. So, if the moments are activity of the mind, then in between those moments of activity are moments of stillness. And life is a flickering of the rising, decaying of conscious, rise and fall. And our minds put together these flickers and create what we experience as a seamless event. So spiritual practice is about getting to know what's in between those flickers. What's in between those flickers of moments is your other half. The other half of your existence that's always going on, but we're unaware of. We're only aware of the active part of our experience of our life. So if life is like a so if life is so if we experience life like a seamless continuum, what I'm saying is that in reality, life is a series of flickers, and our brain takes these flickers. So if you look at the mind, our experience as a rising of consciousness, falling, arising, ar falling, arising. Each peak of awareness is a moment, sort of like a film cell, and our brain puts together these moments into a seamless continuity, just like a movie film cell does. Flicker, 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 flicker. We experience as the continuity. Same thing with our life. Our awareness is arising, falling, arising, falling. And at the peak of each one is a moment, and all we do, all we experience, is just the peaks of these. So what I'm saying is, the spiritual practice is getting to know the other half of your life. If that's the rise, I don't know what you call it, but the bottom of the wave. So there's the active part, there's the inactive part of the wave. And while we experience it as a seamless whole, there's actually a whole other half that we're missing out on to our life. And I actually used a caption to that in my book when I showed this picture. Get that really good. The bottom half of the picture represents what's always going on. That's the still part of your life that's always going on. Whereas the top part would be the flickering. They're moments, and we experience it as a seamless whole, but in actuality, it's not. As I said, it's a flickering of moments. So basically, your spiritual practice is to get to know that other half of your existence, the other half that's always going on, whether you're aware of it or not. So, my practice was based on a book called The Cycle of Day and Night by Nam Khai Norbu. It's a Dzogchen practice. The book actually was based on a teaching probably thousands of years old, and he just retranslated it. But basically, the practice was to cultivate, first get to know that stillness that's always a part of you, and then cultivate it and spend as much time as you can in that stillness throughout your day to wake up and start your practice right there. By trying to be aware of what happened throughout the night. Your dreams, whatever happened, you just try to recapitulate what happened through the night. And then as you're going throughout the day, you're constantly bringing your mind back to the space between your thoughts, the activity, and try to be aware of the inactive part of your experience. And the more time you spend throughout the cycle of day and night practicing this, the more you're going to feel like you're dying. And I think that the reason that people feel like they're dying when they're practicing abiding as aware space is because the more time you spend practicing that, the less real your story as a person seems to be. And I'll explain why. Typically, as I said before, people experience their life as a, or their story as a continual stream, an unbroken story. Because they're unaware of the still aspect of their lives, of their experience. So basically, life is a series of flickers, but if you're unaware of the still aspect of your life, it's going to seem like one seamless whole. So basically, the picture, a better way to diagram this would be to show that each moment, without awareness of the stillness, the still aspect of your life, only being aware of the moving aspect of your life will seem like a continual whole because you're not aware of the still aspect. So, the minute you start to practice meditation, contemplation, anything that's going to cultivate the still aspect of your experience, it's going to seem less convincing or less continual because you're now aware of the other half of your existence. So the more you pay attention to that other half, the still space of your existence, the less real it will ultimately seem because you're seeing it in its entirety. You're not missing out on the still aspect. You're paying attention to the still aspect, so you're seeing things completely as opposed to only a partial perspective of your life. So, that's why spiritual practice is practicing death. The more you practice getting to know your complete self, the more you're going to lose the sense of your story. But, anyway, it's worth it. And happy hunting. All right. My name is Mark, and I'll get out of your way so you can enjoy the view.